So what I wanted to be talking about in this video was just weight loss and weight journey and accepting yourself no matter what weight you're at, you know. For me, with my weight gain and with the story behind my weight, really. Thank you so much for watching this video. As you've seen from the title, it's just gonna be like a girls chit chat, you and me. Welcome into my lounge at home, and hopefully you have your cup of tea, and together we just can sit and have a chit chat and just a real kind of girls moment, you know. So what I wanted to be talking about in this video was just weight loss and weight journey and accepting yourself no matter what weight you're at, you know. For me, with my weight gain and with the story behind my weight, really, is I wasn't a bigger girl before, never was actually. Although I was always kind of a bit, I tended to be a bit more muscular, like because I played a lot of sports when I was younger. I just tended to have a bit more of an athletic kind of, yeah, just thick, you know, sort of physique. That was my body. And for the most part, I liked it. I mean, I never liked that I had like big hips and a big bum and thunder thighs, but you know, it was what it was. And for the most part, I was okay with it, I guess. But anyways, having gotten married and having had kids, especially the pregnancies, because of that, I landed up gaining weight postpartum, funnily enough. You know, if you're keeping up with the world news, you know about Kate Middleton. She's pregnant and she has hyperemesis gravidarum, which is like severe morning sickness. And that's what I had with both of my kids as well. Like, I was throwing up, I think one day we counted, I threw up like 15 times in one day. It was crazy. So much so that like I actually ended up wrecking some of the enamel of my teeth, actually. So that's just how bad it was, right? But yeah, so we did, you know, we did go through a very difficult pregnancy with both of my kids. But how that ties in with weight is that one of the key things with hyperemesis gravidarum is that you actually lose a lot of weight. You lose almost like, I don't want to exaggerate, but it's something like 5% of your body weight that you had before. And what happened with me is that because I was not keeping down any food, any fluids, I was being rushed in and out of hospital for dehydration and all of that stuff. What ended up happening is that my body kind of went into starvation mode because I was not eating like at all. And any little that I was eating, it wasn't staying down. So my body went into like starvation mode, you know, because I was not eating for the whole 9 months pretty much. And then when I had my girl and when I had my boy, because your body does not know when the next meal is coming, it's gonna take it a while to realize that okay, the pregnancy is over and you're back to being normal. It just kind of stores any food that you do eat, right? And then it doesn't help that I wasn't as active as I used to be before, so you know, I gained some weight postpartum. And that was a bit hard for me because, like I said, I'm not used to being bigger, and I had my self-esteem issues, you know, feeling like I'm a big girl and am I still that cute and does hubby still love me and, you know, all of those things, and dealing with that. And yeah, it was a bit hard, you know, to kind of embrace and be comfortable with the new me. I did have my challenges with it. There are things that I wasn't happy about. You know, I had stretch marks in places that I never had stretch marks before. Yeah, my body was just super different. Apologies for the car driving past. You know, I've closed the curtains in the hopes of trying to dampen the sound a bit more. But one day, you know, I'll have a studio that I can record in. But for now, it is what it is. Going back to what I was saying, yeah, like, you know, I struggled a lot with accepting the new me, like accepting the stretch marks that I never had before and just being different. I had a bit of a difficult time with that. Like, I wasn't feeling myself as much. I wasn't feeling as cute. I wasn't, you know, I just wasn't feeling me. But what I came to realize with that is that I can still 100% be me, because what makes me is the person that I am and not the number on a scale. Now, granted, you know, I feel like I need to put work into my body and losing weight, not because it will make me more attractive and more beautiful and more sexy, but just because I feel like for the sake of my health, for the sake of teaching my kids to look after themselves, to eat healthy, to exercise, to just really take care of themselves, I feel like it's really important for me to do what I preach to my kids, you know, if that makes sense. Like, oh yeah, you tell us to eat healthy, but you're not doing it, you know. So I don't want to come across as a hypocrite to my kids. So, you know, I want to tell my kids, you know, exercise, be healthy and all that jazz. And I want them to be able to look at me and be like, yeah, mommy is saying this and it's true for her in life. So for that reason, I want to get back into shape. I do want to lose weight. But what I really wanted to convey to you through this video is that I feel like, you know, whether you're plus size, whether you're skinny, whether you're somewhere in between, I just wanted you to know that the scale does not dictate who you are. It does not validate you as a person. It does not mean that you're beautiful or you're ugly because of a number on a scale. You know, by all means, like I'm saying, if you want to exercise and get back into shape, like, for, you know, by all means, go for it, you know. But I just want you to know that you are not your figure. You're not the number on a scale. You're not other people's perception of you. Like, oh yeah, she's pretty for a fat girl. Or she's pretty for a skinny girl. Oh, she got no... It doesn't matter what people are saying. You know, don't worry too much about that. Be comfortable in your own skin and embrace yourself for who you truly are through all the seasons of your life. You know, like I said to you, I started out being... smaller, and I had a smaller figure and a smaller frame, but I did have a big hips and a big bum and thunder thighs. But you know, I started out being smaller and now I've gained some weight. But you know what, at the end of the day, I am still the same person regardless of my size. I am still fiercely and wonderfully made in God's image. I am still the same caring wife and mother and sister and friend that I was before. It doesn't matter now that I've got more stretch marks and more cellulite and, you know, more flabby arms than I did before, because those things, number one, they tell a story, okay? They tell a very beautiful story. And here's the thing, with your body and with the scars that you have in your body, they tell a very beautiful story. They tell that you survived. Like, for example, for me, hyperemesis gravidarum, it was a very, very debilitating sickness. I was in bed for 9 months straight. It was so hard. First pregnancy, second pregnancy. It was incredibly difficult. But you know what? Here's the thing. I've got extra stretch marks on my arms. I've got it on my belly. I've got it on my love handles. My love handles. You know, I've got it there. Ooh, I'm nearly about to fall here. I've got it on my love handles, my thighs, my bum, my whatever. But you know what? Those scars, those stretch marks, you know, I've got a C-section scar. I had my kids via C-section. Number one, you know, with my daughter, it didn't work out to have a natural birth. We tried and it just didn't work. So we ended up having to have an emergency C-section. And then with my son, we just had another one. But you know what? Those scars, this is what I'm saying. The scars, the stretch marks, the cellulite, they tell a story, you know. The stretch marks, you're not going to have your baby perfect skin from when you were a baby. You've grown. You've become a woman. Your body has developed, you know. And that tells the story that you are now a woman, you know. You're not a kid anymore. You're now a woman. So kind of like fall in love with your stretch marks and be like, you know what? Yes, they tell a story. I love my C-section scar because it shows that I brought life into this world, that I survived two very difficult pregnancies, and I mean very difficult pregnancies, okay? With my daughter, I nearly miscarried her twice. They don't know why. Both times I just started bleeding randomly. And then I nearly went into preterm labor with her once. And that was just so hard. On top of that, I had hyperemesis gravidarum. Let me tell you, that was such a wild ride. I'm probably going to have a story time about that one day in the future. But that was such a wild ride, you know. But I survived, right? It was crazy. I mean, we had moments where my husband and I, we pulled up on the side of the road. We're both crying our eyes out. I'm in hospital for like days on end. They're running tests on me to find out what's wrong with me, how can they fix it or whatever. You know, it was hard. But here's the thing. I got the scar, the C-section scar. I got the stretch marks. I got the extracellulite, and I survived. And for all of my travel today, I have a beautiful 3-year-old girl. She is absolutely gorgeous. She's the apple of my eye, and I love her. And if having her means that I had to go through a rubbish pregnancy, then you know what? Yes, I'm thankful. I am a survivor. And just like I have a story that is written on my body and the scars that tells of who I am and what I've survived and what I've been through. I want to challenge you to look at your body, to look at your stretch marks, your cellulite, your whatever, and look at the story that it tells, okay? Maybe you have saggy skin because you were bigger and you lost weight and you've got like excess skin or whatever. But you know what? That excess skin shows that you're a fighter, that you did not give up, you did not quit, you kept going until you reached your weight loss goal, okay? Maybe you gained weight through a breakup or through the loss or something, and your body shows the grief. You know, and maybe you need to look at your body and be like, yes, you know what? I've gone through a time of grieving, but now I need to rise up from it. You know what I'm saying? I feel like I need to be playing instrumental music in this part that's just really motivating, you know? But yeah, I just want to challenge you with that, to just to look at your body and to be okay with who you see staring back at you in the mirror, you know? So I am gonna be losing weight. I am gonna be on a weight loss journey, and I'm gonna keep you updated on how that goes. But I just wanted you to know that, you know, whether you're working at losing weight or whether you're comfortable with where you're at, whether you're skinny or, you know, whether you're plus size or whatever, I just want you to know that you're not the number on a scale. You're not other people's perceptions of you. You're not even your own perception of you sometimes, because sometimes how we perceive ourselves is wrong. We can perceive ourselves as worthless and unbeautiful. Is unbeautiful a word? Unbeautiful, you know. We can just look at ourselves and define ourselves by our flaws. But today, I just want to challenge you to look in the mirror, okay? Stand in your undies, okay? At the end of this video, go stand in your undies in front of a full-length mirror and look at the stretch marks and the cellulite and see the story that your body tells. And I'm pretty sure it's a story that is remarkable. It says that you're a survivor, that you're strong, that you know what, you were bent, but you were not broken. Okay, and so just embrace that. And by all means, if there's changes that you want to make, change them, but make them for the right reason. Okay, like I've shared with you, I'm going to be losing weight, but I'm not doing that so that I can be sexy. I'm just doing that so that I can be healthy, you know. And if you want to lose weight because you want to be healthy, that's a good thing. And if you're comfortable with where you're at, that's a good thing. As long as at the end of the day, you know what your true value and your true worth is, and that is not based on the number on a scale. Does that make sense? So, anyways, that is my 13 minute and 12 second piece of encouragement. I really hope that, you know, whenever you're watching this video, that it just really hits you in the heart, and that you know that, you know what, no matter my size, no matter whether I wear glasses, I have freckles, I'm skinny, I'm whatever, you're beautiful just as you are. God did not make a mistake when he made you. You're fearfully and wonderfully made. And in your own way, you represent and you bring a certain kind of beauty in the world that is just unique to you. So thank you for being the beauty that you are. Thank you for sharing it with the world. And I just really hope that this message encourages you. So if you've really enjoyed this video, if it's really encouraged you, I just hope that you'll share it amongst your girlfriends and even some men in your life or whoever, you know. Let's get the word out there, the message out there that, you know what, I am comfortable being me. Hashtag I am comfortable being me. I think we can make that a thing. Let's make that a thing. I am comfortable being me. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you so much for taking your time to just listen to what's on my heart. And I trust that it connected with you and in your heart. And if you like the video, thumbs up it, share it, subscribe to this channel if you like what it's about, and connect with me on social media. I am on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, right here on YouTube and Pinterest as well. The name to look for is Dance in My Crown, and I would love to hear your story about how you are learning or have learned to be comfortable in your own skin. If you want to share that with me, if you want to share your own story with me, drop it in the comment section below. I'd really want to hear from you. Thanks again for watching this video, and I will catch up with you in either the next blog. Listen to me. Thanks for watching. I will catch up with you in the next blog post or podcast or YouTube video. Okay, bye.